Now next, a simple low-tech health solution that is benefiting the poorest of the poor in Kenya. Paul Sisko reports.
Kibera in Nairobi. Up to a million people live in Kenya's biggest slum. Here, water and sanitation problems loom large. Keltuma Tahir, a mother of six, is known by many as Mama Sotis. Sotis is short for solar water disinfection, a simple, life-saving treatment project and process she promotes and teaches, purifying water using the sun, a resource readily available in Kibera.
Currently, the price of fuel has risen. The price of charcoal has risen. The charcoal I would be able to afford is for cooking, not to boil tap water. This method is easy and saves money.
Tap water is purified simply by placing bottles of it in the sun on reflective surfaces. Kenyan chemist David Kariuki has tested the process and says 6 hours in direct sunlight will kill almost all waterborne disease-carrying germs.
This method is, I would probably say, more effective than boiling, given that you're using the water straight from the treatment facility, as it were. Now, boiling, you'd have to cool it before you drink it, and the container you're cooling it on could have a recontamination.
More and more rooftops are now doubling as water treatment platforms. The project has reached 65,000 households and 15 schools in Kibera. Leah Matusa is the head teacher at Kibera's Makina School.
At the moment, we have 300 pupils. Before we started using treated water sodis, 10 to 15 pupils were getting sick per week. But nowadays, we have only one or two who get sick and who become absent. So the performance has really increased, and even the attendance.
This is one small-scale project that is having a positive effect in Kibera and elsewhere. Worldwide, the technique is used by 2 million people in some 30 countries. But that is just a small fraction of the more than 1 billion people on the planet doing without safe drinking water. Paul Sisko, VOA News.